Welcome back to Running the Gauntlet. This time we've got quite the brew here. I don't really know which birthing pod list is best, so I'm just going to run through all of them. Well, there's rug, there's green, white, blue, and there's like straight black, green, but this one looked like a pretty sweet place to start. And I am doing a video, and I always appreciate when people message me, so even if you interrupt a video, it's no big deal. So this is kind of like the list that Olivier first played in French Nationals, and it's got some pretty sweet stuff going on. So it's obviously a birthing pod deck, so it's got a bunch of one-ofs at each chain, you know, casting cost, the Wormcoil, Frost Titan, Sun Titan, Elesh Norn, Archon, Acidic Slime, then Vincers to abuse Acidic Slimes like the Titans, Metamorph, Baloth, Corruptor. Phantasmal Image is just a fantastic card. It's very cheap, gives you a great two to go get, and it, you know, copies everything. Seagate Oracle as well. And then a sideboard which has some nice ones. I decided to add a bunch of Flash Freezes since it seems like Valakut would be tough for this deck otherwise. And Flash Freeze seems like it'd be pretty good in the mirror too. Anyway, and plus 25 lands, among which are a couple man lands, but not too many. This deck doesn't really need that much action because it's packed with a bunch of stuff to do. So right now I'm playing against Matt Nass, who's playing Caw Blade. And yeah, I'm going to go ahead and mold this. And I don't think I go to 5 here. This isn't a great hand, but on 6 I think it's keepable. Apparently the birthing pod list is just 30 lands. So what I'm looking to draw here is... yeah, that card. Yeah, sometimes it just happens. So now for Cobra, I've got to figure out what the threes are, and it's pretty much Seagate Oracle. All right, let's play a Cobra here. I mean, he can counter it, but I don't think I can afford to not play it. I guess he didn't counter it. Maybe he'll just dismember it instead. And that looks like the case. All right, Cobra down. If he doesn't tap out, I guess Yeah, well, he's tapping out. So, Birthing Pod is coming out. For 3 mana and 2 life, which means that as long as I can resolve creatures, that, you know, I get to get some stuff going. But the fact is, my hand is all expensive spells, so I just need some cheap creatures. That's not exactly it. Alright, go ahead. Tech Edge is pretty annoying here, though. If he's not doing anything, it's not the worst. I mean, if he had like a Nexus or something, it'd be real bad. Alright, now he gets to counter something here. Now I draw that. Alright, well, let's go ahead and get definitely a forest. And I guess this only gets a plains. And what do I want him to counter? No, I'd rather him counter Acidic Slime. That's fine. Plus, Acidic Slime, if he tech edges my green-white land, it'll be harder to cast Acidic Slime later. Whereas Archon still can be cast. And then Archon also sacks to kill something just like Acidic Slime. So I'm not too unhappy here. What does he got? A Gideon? Oh, Archon can actually get Gideon as well. Little known fact, whereas Acidic Slime can't. All right, land? That's not a land. So I can play Archon, but then I can't do it. So let's go back to our deck editor and look at our fours. Metamorph, Solemn, so basically nothing. All right. So I could play Seagate and then get Solemn. Yeah, that seems like a lot sweeter than just playing Archon and passing. All right, would I rather have a bird or, let's see, a land? I'm gonna get a Solemn. I think I'd still rather have a land here. Let's play a bird, and let's crack this for a forest and activate pod. Oop, I do not want to pay any life, and sack this. Solemn Simulacrum, and get, I guess, another plane. No, get another island here. Why not? All right. I think this puts us in a little better shape. If we just went Archon of Justice pass, he could just into the Royal Archon and just completely wreck us. Whereas this, we actually, you know, we got a card off Seagate, we got able to hit another land drop, and we Solemned, and it gives us a good chump blocker for Gideon plus Sword. He could still, like, Wrath here, animate Gideon, equip Sword, hit us, and that wouldn't be great, but he would have to have a Wrath, and I would draw a card off Solemn, which means I could then discard that instead. If he lets us untap and play Archon now with Mana Leak protection, that's pretty sweet. All right, so he's got, I'm sure, a lot of choices. We'll see which one where he goes with it. All right, Gideon's coming in. I guess since he figures Solemn gets sacked to Birthing Pod, he might just get in there instead. Or he's bouncing it? Oh, a Mirror Angel. Fetch land. All right, so he's going as deep as possible. I'm just going to block with the Solemn, I think, since I've already got Birthing Pod kind of filled up here. All right, let's play Archon. So we get a 6-drop now? Jeez. All right. Archon resolves. I guess we could just play this. Birthing Pod. Oh, no, did not want to pay life. All right. And let's see. I'm going to exile Gideon, I think, since that seems like the most annoying thing currently. Let's get something sweet here. All right, I'm going to get a Titan because I want to get up to Elesh Norn next turn. I'm also going to get hit by a sword this turn, since I don't think I can actually stop that. I think I like Sun Titan in getting to Seagate Oracle back. All right. Seagate Oracle. Yeah, get in there, Seagate. And... I guess I'm just going to discard this anyway, so sure, we'll put a bird in hand. I don't want to discard either of my other two cards. So yeah, that looks pretty good. Next turn, I can actually play Wyrmcoil and sack that to Birthing Pod instead. Get out of here. You are no longer wanted. All right. Bird's wearing a sword, which is not surprising. And what's he casting? Is it sweet? Oh, Timely Reinforcements. Okay, sure. Don't want to block with bird. Six... Yeah, I guess we can block with bird. I mean, one way to lose, I guess, is to take damage, unnecessary damage, and then randomly get sorted out. But I think I'm going to be okay here. All right, yeah, tech edging my colonnade. That's fine. And discarding my bird. So then on my turn, he's tapping out, so we get to see his last card. Another Gideon. Okay. Yeah, you know, I can work with this, I think. Since I'm just going to get Elesh Norn, kill all his guys, kill his Gideon. And I'll do it. I even get to discard Obstinate Baeloth to his stupid sword. All right, let's pay a life. One, he's got no cards in hand, so he'd have to peel a Wrath to get out of this. All right, and I get Wyrmcoil tokens. Yeah, this deck does some sweet stuff. All right, take a bite out of crime here. What am I getting back with the Seagate Oracle? I think I might actually, yeah, I'm just going to get back Celestial Colonnade. Oop, I have to attack Gideon, I guess. Or with Sun Titan, not Seagate Oracle is what I meant. Yeah, I'm going to get back Celestial Colonnade since Wrath is one of the few things that can really destroy me here. And if he doesn't draw it, yeah, he's pretty screwed. I mean, I'm at 10 still. He cannot do a whole lot of damage. And then I get to discard Obstinate Baeloth. All right, man, I was so excited. All right, so sideboarding. What's bad in this deck against them? Molotov Massacre seems like kind of bad. Reading Crupper seems okay. Blade Splicer is like mediocre. Obstinate Baeloth's bad. I think I want Acidic Slime. Maybe I'm overloading on the 5-drops. And then, I guess, Master Thief could steal a sword. It might be better just... Yeah, Nature's Claim's okay. I mean, sometimes they run O-Ring. Like, most versions at this point are running at least one or two. You could just put in, like, one of those. I mean, this deck does... I don't think you want to sideboard too much, because, again, you don't... Like, except for, you know, in a very, very focused matchup like Valakut, yeah, a bunch of Flash Freezes are going to be good. But against most matchups, like, you can just take out the appropriate bullets, but that's about it. Because the rest, like, you don't want to cut down the creature density too much. I don't think I want a second Corruptor. I mean, this looks like a... Again, I don't want to overboard for swords and lose to Planeswalkers plus Flash Freezes.